ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And finally, the month of September is here after a few days, and I did not make any video on the August horoscope because I had already made many videos for the retrogression which was going on, like Mercury and then Saturn and Mars. So I didn't want to just stress on the same thing again. But now finally the month of September is here and all the planets will be direct starting the first week of September, and on 27th August near about, Mars is going to be direct finally after 2 months of being retrograde in the sign of Capricorn. And then Mercury is already going to be direct today, which is August, I don't know what's the date today, 19th. And Saturn, the planet of duty, structure, commitment, restriction, is going to be direct in September 6th, I guess, 5th or 6th, near about that time. And finally, Jupiter is also direct, and Venus will be entering the sign of Libra. Okay, so let us discuss this month in detail. Not too much, of course, just overview. And depending on your ascendant, this will vary. The planets will affect you differently, and depending on the dashas and depending on other transits which are happening over your natal positions and the yogas which you have in your chart, this will vary. And if you are interested to know that how these planets will impact you personally or any specific placement in your chart regarding your marriage or your career or your health, then you can go to my website and book a personal reading with me. You will find the link of the website in the description section of this video. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him, and now you will definitely find him because all the planets are going to be direct by September. And if you're new to the channel, then also please subscribe to it. And I have also made the video on Jupiter's transit into Scorpio. It has got around 23,000 views. So if you have not watched it, then please watch it. Okay, so now what's happening is, I will give the transition, how the transition is happening. So by the end of August, Mars will be somewhat stationary and it will just start moving. Okay, and Venus will be in the sign of debilitation till the end of August. So, and Saturn will also be in retrogression. So the end of August and the beginning of September is a bit turbulent time. Turbulent not in the sense that there will be some dangerous things happening like accidents, earthquakes or killings, but we will try to see a different direction in life. So whichever houses, especially Mars and Saturn, are ruling in your chart, we will see that now we are getting a different outlook. There's something which we had been working, like Saturn was retrograde from April, I guess, and from that time we were redoing something. We were doing something which we thought we had done quite good earlier, but then we realized no, it's not happening. Then we started redoing it, or we started refining it. Retrogression also means we are refining the existing things. Not only necessarily that we are doing the same things again, but we might be doing the same existing things in a much better way. But now it is going to stop. September 1st week, Saturn is going to be stationary. Yes, around 3rd, 4th, 5th. Saturn generally stays stationary for 2 days in my experience. So if it is going direct on 6th, then around 4th or 3rd night, you can say it will be stationed. So when Saturn is stationing in the sky, it is a very important time actually, because during that time, you can finally take a new decision. Because see, Saturn is the original ruler of the 10th house and the 11th house. So Saturn, in a way, whichever ascendant you are, it will always control the work ethics, our ability to put hard work in some area of life. And depending on the ascendant, whichever house Saturn is ruling, that thing changes. So for example, if you are a Leo ascendant, then Saturn will rule the 6th house and the 7th house. So then for you, that same duty structure commitment comes in the 6th house of daily work and the 7th house of marriage. And if you are a Cancer, it will go to 7th house and 8th house. So this is how you understand which areas will be affected. So whichever houses Saturn is ruling in your chart, now from September 6th, you will take a new direction there. And always remember, Saturn is not in an ordinary sign. It is in the sign of Sagittarius. And that too, it is in the most crucial part of Sagittarius. What is actually Sagittarius? Sagittarius is the sign which comes after Scorpio. Scorpio is the sign of karmic baggage. All the sins of your past lives are stored in the sign of Scorpio, which is the original 8th house, of course. And that is why we are born, to pay for our sins in this life. So when we come to Sagittarius, we enter Mula Nakshatra first. So if you have not watched my videos on Saturn transit into Mula Nakshatra, then please go and watch it. I have made 2-3 videos. So now what is happening? When Saturn went retrograde in Mula, then we were uprooting the existing things, or we were completing something. Just check which houses Saturn is ruling in your chart. Now when Saturn will go direct, we have uprooted everything and now we will plant new seeds. Because we only uproot things when we want to plant something new, right? We just do not uproot things. When we think that there's a problem in this area, we need to uproot it. And now we will plant the new seeds when Saturn is going direct. Especially for Capricorn and Aquarius, these two ascendants, this time is very important. Because Saturn will only go retrograde and direct in Mula Nakshatra after 30 years, 28-30 years. Which is your ascendant lord. So this is a very important time. So if you are a Capricorn or Aquarius watching this, till November mid or November end, when Saturn is still in Mula Nakshatra, this time is very, 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 very important. Okay? Build foundations, build grounds, and then by that improve your life. So same thing is with Mars. So Mars is going to be direct by the end of August. So by the beginning of September, we will start feeling that whichever houses Mars is ruling. Because see, when Mars was retrograde, it was retrograde in its exaltation sign. So whenever planet is exalted, it feels very happy to exert itself naturally, because it is in the most comfortable sign. Comfortable not in a way that there are no difficulties, but it feels that for me to act, this is the best sign which can be. And when it becomes retrograde, then it's like, imagine a person is like the president of a country. Okay, that's like an exalted planet, very strong, very powerful. And then suddenly he becomes a pauper one day. It's like a jerk. So what happens? Then the entire consciousness gets focused in stabilizing. Because it's like, see, suppose if a planet is retrograde in a normal sign, suppose own sign or Mool Trikon or enemy sign or friend sign, it is a different energy. But when a planet is retrograde in its exaltation, then it is all together a different energy itself. Because suddenly that planet which was feeling like I am the king now feels I am like a beggar. That doesn't mean that the planet gets debilitated, but internally you will feel like that. So whichever houses Mars was ruling in your chart from last 2 months, because it is retrograde in its exaltation sign, you would have definitely felt helpless there. At least I have felt. I don't know about you, but I have felt that okay. And people have also told me, sir, this house, I feel it's not working for me. Why? And when Mars entered Capricorn, somewhere in April, I guess, April, May, June, yes, June 27th, it went retrograde. When Mars had entered Capricorn, we were feeling like, yes, I'm the king of this area, I will do whatever I want. Especially if your ascendant is a movable sign, which means Aries, Cancer, Libra or Capricorn, then Mars is transiting in your Kendra now. Because for you, Kendra, Capricorn falls in your Kendra houses, right? And then Mars is also one of your Kendra lords if you are a movable ascendant. And especially Mool Trikon sign of Mars, Aries, is ruling a Kendra house, so you will feel it more. So you were suddenly feeling that, yes, I am the king in this area, whichever houses Mars is ruling. And then suddenly after June, you started feeling, no man, it's not working. But now again you will start feeling that, yes, I am the king. Now again you will see that whatever I wanted to do, basically when a planet goes retrograde, it wants to do some background work which it did not do earlier. So now the background work is complete. Whatever is required, why does a planet go retrograde? Because when it wants to go direct, it realizes that there is something which I don't have, which I need. So retrogression means the planet went back to get what it needs to go direct. Because no planet wants to go retrograde.
every planet wants to go direct, but when it can't go direct due to something which is lacking inside, it goes retrograde. And because it's like, see, suppose you have entered a territory, exalted planet means it has conquered a big land, suppose Alexander the Great or Genghis Khan or somebody like that, apparent conquerors who have perished, of course. But suddenly, suppose you enter a land which you have conquered, and then suddenly you feel, oh, I never conquered it. It was an illusion. So the jerk is very bad. So June end, many people have written to me that suddenly something has happened. Suddenly our consciousness has shifted to whichever, regarding to whichever areas Mars was ruling in our chart, or is ruling, or it will always rule. But now is the time we have done the background check required, and now is the time we will move forward, depending on the dasha and other planetary positions and yogas in the chart, of course. So this is a very good time. And then apart from that, what is happening is, now Venus is transiting in the month of August. Venus is transiting in its debilitation sign. It's in a very precarious state. It is in the sign of Virgo. Peak debility is going on now, especially now Venus is in around 18 degrees, I guess. And as if that was less, Saturn is throwing its 10th aspect from Sagittarius. That's crazy. It's like a planet which is debilitated, and then Saturn is telling, I will force you to be debilitated. Wherever Saturn sees it, subdues. So now Venus, not only is it feeling terrible in the sign of Virgo, where it is forced to see things in a way that it doesn't want, because Venus gets exalted in Pisces. Because Venus is our ability to love, you see. And Virgo is the sign of fault finding. So whenever Venus transits Virgo, for that month, 25-26 days approximately, you will always find people, they are finding faults. They are focusing on too many unnecessary things. Virgo shows sometimes too many unnecessary things which eat our head. So it's like, suppose you are going to a shop to buy something. You are like, oh, that is 20 rupees, that's $2, that is $3. Which one should I buy? It's like a paralysis after analysis. So that is what happens when Venus is in Virgo. Even if everything is good, we will still feel, oh, my partner is not reciprocating, my partner is not good. And if you are a Libra or a Taurus, you will feel this more. At least for Taurus ascendants, your Lagna Lord is in debility, but it is transiting in a trine, the fifth house. So it is still better. But for Libra, it's terrible, because it's transiting in a Dusthana, that to the 12th house, the worst of the Dusthanas. And it is in debility and aspected by Saturn. Okay? So you will feel it very bad, very difficult. You will feel this very strongly, Libra ascendants. But now what is going to happen? End of the night of 1st September, which is, you can say, roughly beginning of 2nd September, Venus is going to enter the sign of Libra, Mool Trikon sign. Alright? So that means now Venus is entering its Mool Trikon sign, and can you guess till when will it be there in this sign? It will be there till January 2nd or 3rd, I guess, or 1st. So for 4 freaking long months, Venus is going to be in its sign of Libra. It is also going to be retrograde, and then stationary, and then direct. Okay? And there it will be conjunct Jupiter. So this is a very powerful yoga which is happening. So from September 2nd to October 12th, this conjunction will be there. So roughly 40 days, Jupiter and Venus will be conjunct. Okay? And then Mercury will also join this conjunction after some days. And on 11th October, all the four benefics, Jupiter, Mercury, Moon, Venus, will be conjunct in the sign of Libra, of course. And then, depending on wherever Libra is falling, there will be a lot of positive energy which will come. Okay. Apart from that, what will I say? Sun will be in the sign of Leo as the month starts. Of course, we know that 15 degrees it will be in there in the sign of Leo. And then on 15th or 16th, it will enter the sign of Virgo. And then by third week, I think Mercury will also enter the sign of Virgo. So this is quite a good time, actually. See, so now what has happened is, Sun was in Cancer now, okay? And now it has entered Leo. and then it will enter Virgo by mid of September. So from Leo, see, Leo is basically what? Leo is the sign of government, authority, power, position, name, fame. It shows control basically. And Virgo comes after Leo because that shows execution of the control. So when Sun enters Leo, it feels that now I have the power to control things. That is why Leos can be very dominating at times. Leo ascendants, Leo moon, Leo sun sign. These three people I have seen. Or even if you have Sun in the first house, you can also still have this trait. And sometimes even people with Sun in the 10th house, sometimes also I have seen. Dominating not in a bad sense, but they have this idea that I should control the way things are around me. So the lesson when Sun is in Leo is to let go of control. Oh my God. Because the more you try to control, you will be frustrated. You should try to control your bad habits, not other people. When Sun is in Leo, it is the best time to make a resolution that I will not indulge in one of the bad habits, at least for that month. And this can be done on a Sunday morning. Very good it is. Today you are seeing this video, you can do this next Sunday. It will be fantastic. And then when Sun goes to Virgo, it will be with an exalted Mercury, remember. So it is a fantastic time to put the things into real practice. And then you will have the support of Jupiter and Venus in Libra. So you will also be able to negotiate. Jupiter, Venus will be conjunct the entire month of September. And when these two are conjunct, because these two are the greatest of the benefics. Yes, there are no other benefics who are more beneficial than Jupiter and Venus because they represent the gurus. So if this is happening in your Kendra house, Kendra houses 1, 4, 7, 10, which means if you are a movable ascendant, Aries again, Cancer, Libra and Capricorn, then this is a fantastic time for you, the month of September. Because now you will get all the necessary guidance which you will require, which you will need. Because Jupiter and Venus, Jupiter is the spiritual guru and Venus is the materialistic guru. So you will get all the necessary guidance. Okay, and apart from that, what should I say? You will have a lot of happiness in that area because these two planets represent happiness, expansion, beauty, comfort, growth, happiness, delight, food. So if this is happening in your second house, your weight will increase. Or even if this is happening in your fifth house, then also your weight will increase because you will indulge in too much eating, you see. Okay, and then Mercury will also enter Virgo, as I said, by third week. So Mercury is going to be exalted there. So fantastic time it is for the Virgo ascendants. You will feel a lot of relief after this crazy debilitation of Mercury which is going on now. And finally it has Mercury is in a water sign and retrograde. So you will feel a lot of relief when Mercury goes to Leo and then when it goes to Virgo. Okay, so basically the energy is very harmonious now to do things, to go ahead, to move forward, to put our plans into execution. Now all the blockages will be cleared and happy times will come depending on your dasha and your chart and the natal planets and yogas. Okay, so there you go. If you want to know how this month of September will be for you depending on your individual chart and your yogas, then you can please go to my website and book a reading. You will find the link of the website in the description section of this video below. And if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who wants to know how the month of September will be. Okay, so great time it is. Until next time, wish you good luck. Bye bye. See you.